what is a pledge? Let's first examine what a pledge is. I am conveying my wish to make an organ donation after my death. So that's a pledge. So I carry a donor card with me. And the most important thing when you pledge your organs is to tell your family. If you don't tell your family, your pledge is of no use, because tomorrow I am on ventilator and I am declared brain dead. I'm not the one going to call, you know, Mohan Foundation or any similar agency to make an organ donation. It's the family that has to be invested in this cause. So that is why we say organ donation is all about family tradition. Everyone in the family has to be equally enthused to make an organ donation happen. So that's the first step. So the decision makers have to be part of this. The second step is, when a brain death happens in a hospital, what happens? So a lot of them ask me, how are we going to know, you know, what is the link? How are you going to ensure that my donation happens?
Right.
So when a brain death happens in the hospital, most of the, you know, all the transplant centers mandatorily, according to the Transplantation of Human Organs Act, has to have a trained transplant coordinator who is trained in counseling the families for organ donation.
Right.
So all large hospitals will have a transplant coordinator. That's one. Even if the brain death does not happen in a licensed transplant center, most of the hospitals know about organ donation. They know about the central agency. Like Dr. Nagesh mentioned about Jeevandan in Hyderabad. There is ZTCC in Mumbai. There is Jeevasarthakate in Karnataka. So there are local government bodies, and most of the hospitals know about these local bodies. So they reach out to them, and the transplant coordinators from there go and counsel the family and motivate them to donate their loved one's organs. Right. And if they give consent, there is a certain stipulated form, a consent form, according to the Transplantation of Human Organs Act, where the next of kin has to sign on the consent form along with two witnesses. So once the consent is obtained, there are two things that are possibilities. One is, it depends upon what is the cause of brain death.
Right.
If the cause of brain death is due to a road traffic accident, any road traffic accident, as you know, are medico-legal cases. They are subjected to, you know, police verification.
Right.
So when a death happens, in the case of road traffic accident victims, it has to be, if once the consent is obtained, it has to be notified to the local police. The local police will come to the hospital and talk to the family and write the panchanama. And then they give us a go-ahead. Simultaneously, the local forensic authorities have to be notified. They will also come and look at the body, examine, and then, you know, they will look at the medical record, and then they will give us a go-ahead. Once these two agencies give us a go-ahead, only then, you know, simultaneously, we also talk to the local government body, that is Jeevandan in case of Telangana, saying that there is a potential organ donor and that the family has given consent. So in the background, they take care of organ distribution. In most of the cases, you know, because if the organ donation is happening in a transplant, licensed transplant center, one kidney is retained in the same hospital for their own patients.
Right.
The second kidney goes for distribution to the organ sharing pool. And if the center is also doing a liver transplant, you know, it is most likely that the liver will also go to them. And then the heart will be distributed depending upon the viability of the organs.
Right.
So Jeevandan is the one that takes care of organ distribution. So most of these donations happen, the organ retrievals happen in the night, because during the day, the theater is engaged for regular surgeries.
Right.
So we obtain the consent, and according to Transplantation of Human Organs Act, two brain death declarations have to happen with an interval of 6 hours.
Right.
In the case of children, it has to happen with a gap of at least 15, you know, to 24 hours. So, when all of this is happening in the background, the ICU doctors maintain the brain dead donor. The potential donor has to be maintained because the brain is completely dead. When the brain is dead, the brain is the controller of the body. When the brain is dead, all our other organs also start acting up.
Right.
So the intensivists have to ensure that the heart, the liver, the kidneys are all functioning to the optimal level.
Right.
That is what we call brain death maintenance. So the ICU doctors take care of that. The transplant coordinators and the other, you know, administrative managerial staff take care of coordinating with the police and forensic bodies. And again, the transplant coordinator takes care of informing Jeevandan, the local government body. They all in turn distribute the organs to the other hospitals. So the transplant coordinator has to coordinate with all those hospitals and fix a time for organ retrieval. And at that time, all the retrieval teams come together, you know. If the transplant coordinator says the organs are going to be retrieved at 12 midnight, all the teams come together and the potential donor is wheeled into the operating room.
Right.
And once the donor is wheeled into the operating room, all the retrieval teams work together. First, you know, the heart is retrieved. Organ retrieval is, you know, like an open heart surgery. From the throat until the navel, we open up. First the heart is retrieved, then the liver is retrieved, then the kidneys are retrieved. It is in this order it is normally retrieved. Finally, the IBANG team will come and take the corneas. So this entire process takes about 3 to 4 hours, sometimes 5 hours also.
Right.
So when we take the consent from the family asks us the first and foremost question.
Correct.
When will you give us the body?
Correct. That was my next question.
Yeah. Right. So they will ask us. So we do, you know, we work backwards. We do our own math. How long will the forensic and, you know, the police take to come and give us a go ahead? Then we fix up, you know, with the theater. When is the theater going to be ready?
Right.
Then the retrieval. And then we try and give the body to the family by 5 o'clock, you know, by sunrise, we try and give the body so that they can take the body home, or if they're going to their nearby village, they're able to do that.
Right.
So this is the case, you know, the entire process could take anywhere between 12 to 18 hours.
Right.
So this is the most difficult part. That is why we say the transplant coordinators are not transplant counselors. They are transplant coordinators because they have to coordinate with various agencies and various departments within the hospital.
Right, right.
If it is a simple, you know, intracerebral bleed or a brain hemorrhage case, it's not a medico-legal case. It's a non-MLC. So the police or the forensic authorities are not involved in this. So it becomes a very simple case. And we'll be able to hand over the body much earlier to the families.
Right.
So every transplant coordinator is in the know of all these things. So they respond to the families accordingly.